माननीय सदस्य, एक मिनट, आप रक्षा मंत्री जी कुछ कह रहे हैं, सुनना चाहते हैं? रक्षा मंत्री जी कुछ कह रहे हैं? नो, तो श्रीमती अपरिजिता सारंगी
society. But I strongly feel that this is a historic piece of legislation which has the potential to change the lives of lakhs of transgenders residing in our country, and I must say that they are an integral part of our society. If you look at the statistics, there are about 19 lakh transgenders in our country, and out of these 19 lakhs, 4,779 around stay in my state, Orissa, where I come from. So during my tenure as a civil servant, I have very closely interacted with this segment of the community, and there have been lots of interactions with them, and I have seen their struggle from very close quarters. Their non-acceptance in the mainstream society is a gross violation of the fundamental right to equality and also their right to life and personal liberty. I think with the passage of this bill, we will be ensuring that their fundamental rights and constitutional rights are restored. This is an extremely important bill, and we should unanimously resolve to pass this bill. So let me tell you, this particular bill is not new to the Lok Sabha. It has come to the Lok Sabha, it was passed by the Lok Sabha, it had also been sent to the Parliamentary Standing Committee. And the Parliamentary Standing Committee gave a number of recommendations. And I'm very happy to inform the House, and I convey my appreciation to Honorable Minister, Social Justice and Empowerment, and his team for analyzing all the recommendations and incorporating as many recommendations as possible. So this is a very comprehensive scheme at this juncture. Sir, as I talk to you, I am reminded of the judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court, which was passed in 2014. I call it a landmark judgment, because that particular judgment termed the transgender as third gender. I underscore, this particular judgment termed the transgender as third gender. And I would like to read out the judgment of the Honorable Judge in this particular case. The Honorable Judge has said, I read out as it was. Recognition of transgender as a third gender is not a social or medical issue, but a human rights issue, and the spirit of the Constitution is to provide equal opportunity to every citizen to grow and attain their potential, irrespective of caste, religion or gender. To bring into effect this order of the Honorable Supreme Court, the bill has been introduced in the Lok Sabha and the bill is required to be passed. Sir, if we read the bill, there are a couple of salient features which I would definitely like to put forth before the House. I hereby compliment Honorable Minister and the Ministry for scrapping the earlier proposal of identification or recognition of the transgender through a district screening committee. The proposal was to form a district screening committee comprising the district health officer, the chief medical officer, a transgender from the community of transgenders, a psychologist, But fortunately, the ministry in fact has scrapped this particular proposal, and at this juncture, it has been stated very clearly in the bill that now a person to be identified as a transgender will be going to self-identification exercise, and the district magistrate will issue a certificate to that effect. So this is definitely a very progressive step taken by the ministry. We must commend the efforts of the ministry. The second thing which I would like to highlight, in response to the public opinion, the ministry has also deleted a provision thereby decriminalizing begging. For as we know, many of our transgender friends are dependent on begging for their livelihood. Now it has also been taken up by the ministry, and begging for this particular segment has been decriminalized, so that they are given some time before they actually move to alternative occupation. So this is the second thing which has been done, very rightly so. And the third and very important, sir, I would like to bring to the knowledge of the House is the proposal which the bill envisages to set up a national council headed by the Honorable Minister of Social Justice and Empowerment. This particular council's role is very significant. They would be actually looking into the execution of policy, the legislation, and they would overall monitor the welfare measures that are taken up for the welfare of the transgender person. This particular council will also like to address and try to address the grievances of the transgender person. So the bill prohibits discrimination against transgender persons in areas such as education, healthcare and employment. It directs the central and state governments to take up various welfare measures for the transgender person, and offenses against the transgender person, like forcing them to beg, denial of access to public place, and their mental, physical and sexual abuse, etc., will be penalized, and the penalty is up to 2 years of imprisonment with fine. So the passage of this bill, let me honestly tell you, will empower a very vulnerable segment of our society, and this is definitely a very concrete step in the direction of our Honorable Prime Minister's clarion call to the nation of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas or Sabka Vishwas. This bill will actually strengthen the Prime Minister's resolve. Sir, I must say that very good thing about our government is we are learning from others, and this calls for lot of broad-mindedness and large-heartedness. We have been looking into the best practices of other countries, and we have been learning from them. It is not that this bill is new to India. In fact, there are countries which have tried to go for welfare measures for the transgenders, and they have gone for significant legislation. Let me name three countries before you. In this August House, I would like to mention three countries, Australia, Germany and Tasmania. In fact, in Australia, there is a Sex Discrimination Act of 1984, which makes it unlawful for any person to be treated less favorably if there are certain gender-related issues on the basis of which he is treated like that. And there are many provisions to ban this kind of discrimination. I would also like to mention the Equal Treatment Act of Germany, which actually bans discrimination based on sexual orientation. So very recently, in fact, let me honestly tell you, very recently, Tasmania has passed legislation related to the welfare measures for the transgender community. Sir, I would like to conclude with very significant, very important words of Ban Ki-moon, the UN Secretary General, also a Nobel laureate. Wonderful words, sir. I would like to, in fact, say all those things in this particular house. I would like to quote Mr. Ban Ki-moon. He has said, "To those who are gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender, I must say they are not alone. Their struggle for putting an end to violence and discrimination is a shared struggle. I call upon all countries and people to stand with them. I stand with them. All of us should stand with them. The historic shift is underway. We need to educate the people. The time has come. These were the words of Ban Ki-moon, the UN Secretary General and Nobel laureate. So I would make an appeal to this particular house, this August house, to unanimously resolve to do something very concrete for the welfare of the transgender community. And the time has come. We must resolve to come together.